Relationship advice. Update. My, 37 male, girlfriends, 34 female, daughter, 13 female, claimed I violated her. Now I'm proved innocent, my girlfriend wants to reconcile, but I'm not sure I want to. Original post. We've been going out for the best part of 2 years. It was going amazingly well, and because of lockdown, we moved in together. She is just the one daughter, and I always thought we got on well. Last week, I got home from work and I noticed her and her daughter were not in. I didn't really think it was strange, but I then was contacted by the police asking me to go in and see them, which I did. Basically, her daughter claims I violated her. I didn't, of course, absolutely denied it, and the police asked me permission to search my house, which I did. They examined the daughter, didn't find anything, and she basically was interviewed and admitted she made it up. She admitted her dad, who's a real wrong un, was telling her she needed to say that so it could get me out the picture and he might be able to be back in her life. He's not been in it for a while, and hasn't long started to make contact and spend time with her, and we've noticed she's changed a bit lately. Acting out, being disrespectful, that sort of thing. If I ask her to do something, you're not my freaking dad, etc. Naturally, I'm relieved, but I'm angry, upset, and just really confused. My girlfriend made contact, saying she wants to move back in, and we look into picking up where we left off. I told her no way, because I can't trust her daughter yet, and don't really want to be around her, and I'm not sure I want her living under my roof. She said she's only a kid, and I shouldn't hold it against her, and she was being manipulated. I know that's true, but I can't look past how horrible it was. She also says as a mom, she did what she has to do, and as horrible as it was, she'd do it again in a heartbeat, so can't say she apologizes. I mean, I get that, but it doesn't make anything easier, and I can't apologize for how I feel too. So here I am, I don't know what to do. She's staying with her mom until we can talk, but I genuinely don't know what way it'll go. Do I take her back and move on? Or shall I cut my losses? Edited to add, it's bad enough what happened. What's making it feels all worse is that, I feel like she should be a bit more empathetic and apologize at least for what happened, and what the kid did. But she's not doing that. Edit 2, Jesus Christ. I'm not a police apologist or anything, but what is it with people in this thread and the police? They did a great job, investigated properly, and my name is cleared and I have no further involvement with them. I just don't understand why people have a problem with me stating the facts or even not being negative about them. Now for the top advice before the update. What your ex-girlfriend doesn't get is that, there is a difference between being angry at a child, and protecting yourself. You don't have to hold a grudge against a manipulated 13-year-old, in order to conclude that you have to stay away from her because she can put you in a lot of trouble. Exactly. I feel like she just thinks we can just carry on as if nothing happened. I'd move on from this one, mate. Cut your losses. You can't trust her to not do it again, and they might believe her if she makes multiple accusations against you. Your girlfriend did the right thing by her daughter, but I don't think this can be a relationship again. What if you need to discipline her daughter one day? Not physically, but like grounding her or something, and she makes up crap again? Not worth the risk. Exactly, it makes me extremely hesitant to even talk to her again. I don't think it's a good idea to continue. Yes, the girl was manipulated by her dad, but if it happened once, why shouldn't it happen again? Yes, as a mom, your girlfriend did right by her daughter. However, would you be able to even consider letting her and the girl move back in, knowing that you are in constant danger of being wronged again? Sorry, but I think you should move on and let them sort out the mess with the dad alone. Exactly, I just don't trust her daughter anymore. And if you can't trust someone under your own roof, there's not much chance of building that back up. And now for the update. I broke up with her. Thank you all honestly, for all the advice and reassurance. I honestly already knew that I wanted to finish it ever before my last post, but I just needed others to write it out to verify it in my own mind. A few people said, why is this even a question? Well, in all honesty, it was mainly because I'm not the most self-confident of guys. You see, even though I'm told I'm a great guy and a good catch, I've only ever been in 3 serious relationships and actually active with 7 women including her, and she couldn't believe it when I told her I'd been single for a while before I met her. I don't have a lot of confidence with women. So, I was genuinely weighing up if I should stay with her as I might not meet anyone else for a while, and might not be able to do better, as sad as that sounds. Plus, I was worried if I do meet someone else, How do I explain how my last relationship ended? Oh yeah, me and my ex didn't work out because her 13-year-old daughter claimed I was touching her and I didn't ever want to see her again. But she later admitted it was wrong and her dad put her up to it, and the police cleared me. I'm totally innocent, honest. So, I suppose looking at myself, I've got a lot to work on before I consider dating again. So, to elaborate on the breakup but keep it salient, I told her to come over last night. Said to her, I agree what she did was right by her daughter and I would do the same if I had a child that told me that. But I think she's out of order for not apologizing for what I've been through, or showing me any empathy. I said I can't trust her daughter anymore, and don't want to be around her, or have her in my life. So that's it, I'm finishing with her. I also said there's too much drama, I don't want her ex interfering in my life. I didn't sign up for that. She started really crying, saying she's so sorry etc., but I told her it's too late, she should have done that as soon as she knew I was innocent. I told her to go back to her mom's and think about how she wants to get her and her daughter's stuff back, and call me in a few days when she's decided. More tears, but she then after a while, asked if it would make any difference if her daughter apologized? I said no, I never want to talk to her again, I'm especially done with her. And I explained why. Not only am I so angry with her, I can't trust her. And what she did, makes me angry for another reason too. Basically, I was violated as a child by an older male family member when I was 7. It messed me up for a long time. So, to have someone lie about something so disgusting, it fills me up with a lot of rage. She, my ex, had no idea, I never told her in our relationship at all. If she knew, she would definitely have apologized. I got so annoyed about that. Like, why does knowing what I went through make me more worthy of empathy? Does not ruining your boyfriend's life make me less of an apology? I went off on a rant about that, I was so pissed off. So, after I had my rant about it, I told her to leave and we'll talk in a few days about when to start collecting her stuff. I feel mixed, justified in ending it, but sad it's over. Like we were amazing up until this. Really started to bond as a team. Lots of good moments. My dog's missing them too, he sat by the door crying after she left. Edit. Just to get this out the way, let's stop with this, you let the father win, or, he's won talk. He's not really won anything. He's alienated his daughter, ex hates him and the police are looking for him. Not only to mention, if he happened to cause me or my family any more trouble or bother us again, it'll end up very badly for him. He may have won the battle, but he's certainly lost the war. Now for some top comments. Really sorry you had to go through all this. Breaking up was 100% the right choice, as you can leave with a clear name and hopefully the daughter gets professional help. I hope she does too, if she's as good a mom as she was when she reported me, then I'm sure she will. I also hope your ex teach her daughter the consequences of a lie, especially this kind of claim. She could have ruined someone's life. That kid needs to know victims of violations have to fight to defend their truth, and go through hell. When someone lies, it doesn't help them. I hope this child never have to actually experience it for real, because someone can use her lie against her. You went through your own hell, and that may be the reason for your low confidence. I would advise you to talk to someone, especially after all this drama. It is important you take care of yourself. Sometimes there is no solution. Yes, she did right by her daughter. But there isn't really any coming back from that type of claims. Absolutely. Even if I did take her back, I'd always look at her knowing at one point in my life, this woman believed I did something awful to her daughter. There's no way of changing that. Hang on, if the daughter said her real father put her up to a false allegation, where did that go? A. The mother wasn't quoted as having any opinion on that, and B. What do the police intend to do with that knowledge? They're looking for him as far as I know. They're not taking it lightly. Good. He should be charged with something, especially if the daughter came clean with authorities and told them that her father told her to accuse you. The next story is titled, Today I Messed Up by Helping Ruin My Son's Life. My son has been in college since last fall. Last November, my 16-year-old stepdaughter brought up allegations that my son had forced her repeatedly for several years. I confronted my son, and he categorically denied it. But I knew that even though he was my son, I could not defend him for such an awful act. My wife and I reported him to the authorities. My son was arrested in December, and held in prison for several weeks because I refused to provide him bail money. He was eventually expelled from his Ivy League college. In the middle of January, my stepdaughter broke down and admitted she lied about everything. She had actually been having intercourse with her boyfriend, and was scared the news would reach us. The charges were dismissed, and my son was released immediately, but the damage was done. His first girlfriend from college ended things with him. The news spread about the claims, and all his childhood friends have decided to just stay away from him, even though I called each and every one of them personally. I have called the school and explained the situation, and even though they sympathized, they said he needed to reapply for the next school year and go through the admissions process again. My son is understandably furious at us. He has moved back home and refuses to talk to me at all. Both my wife and I have apologized to him repeatedly. We have banned my stepdaughter from our home permanently, and she has been sent to live with her father in another state. My wife and I also agreed to completely disinherit her from our wills. It has been a very painful situation. All of us started therapy. The realization of how badly I ruined my son's life hit me when I picked up his first prescription of antidepressants today. I bawled my eyes out in my car. He is the pride and joy of my life. He is outgoing, funny, intelligent, and the kindest person I know. But when I handed him his medication, I could not even recognize him. He locks himself in his room, does not eat properly, and has lost several pounds so far. Whenever I try talking to him, I just see the hate he has for me in his eyes. I don't know if I can ever get him to love me again. I know he is on Reddit very often. T, if you are reading, I want to tell you again how sorry your stepmom and I are. I promise I will get you into college again. I know I can't get you back the year you lost, but I will do everything in my power to make this right. Everything I have has always been for you. I hope you will give me a chance to fix this. I love you so much it hurts. I failed as a father and I hope one day you will forgive me. Now for the top comments. Dear God, you messed up. That stepdaughter, yay, she needs to go to jail for making untrue claims. What she did is so despicable and wrong, I have no words to describe it. But seriously, what I want to know is, why if OP your son was innocent, without real proof, they locked him up ASAP like that? Yes, I know R is taken as a super serious crime, but you need to explain the trial and whatnot. We are missing part of the story here. That crap is defamation, it actually is a crime. That's insane, why on earth would she say that? Because taking responsibilities for your actions is harder than throwing someone else under a bus. She was scared of getting in trouble for sleeping with her boyfriend, so it was much easier to say her stepbrother violated her. There is absolutely nothing you can do that would make up what you and her psychopath stepdaughter did to your son. How is your stepdaughter not in prison? Did you report it to the police? You decided your son's mistake, which didn't even take place, was worth punishment by the law, yet you are letting a crazy run amok. We have a winner. You want to make amends? Start by showing you're willing to hold the guilty party accountable. You made that choice with your son. To not make that same choice with a stepdaughter is a slap in the freaking face and hugely hypocritical. Yeah, you aren't ever making a comeback on this one. As much as you say you love your son, he's innocent until proven guilty, and you refuse to post his freaking bail so he could actually live his life until the possible conviction. That doesn't sound like love to me. The girl needs to be prosecuted, if at all possible. Do everything in your power to try, you owe your son that at least. You probably killed every ounce of trust he's ever had. You can't immediately turn on your kids like that, it's inexcusable. Feeling bad about it now does jack about the situation. Your son is very likely going to hate you for the rest of his life. I hope you enjoy the crappiest retirement home in the area. You done messed up, and the only person I feel bad for here is your son. To add upon this, I would recommend doing everything you can to make his life easier as well. Your relationship with him is unlikely to recover, but you should ensure he does not continually sink into depression or worse. Damn. You raised a child until college, then systematically decimated his life on baseless claims. You may even want to look into therapy for yourself. I imagine knowing you destroyed the joy of your life will be very psychologically damaging. The last story is titled, My Sister-in-Law, 14 female, claimed I, 26 male, impregnated her. My sister-in-law, who is 14, got pregnant, and when her parents found out, she lied and told them that I was the father. My wife left to be with her family when this broke, and her father was in a rage. I got a lawyer. The lawyer I got told me I needed to pack up, take off work, and stay somewhere where my wife and her family wouldn't know where to find me. Boy, was he right. The next day, our apartment was broken into by my father-in-law and completely trashed it with a baseball bat. My neighbors called the police obviously, and he ended up getting arrested but bailed out by my mother-in-law the next day. My wife's entire family constantly texting and calling, to say how horrible of a person I was. My lawyer met with the family and their lawyer, to tell them I denied all the accusations and that I wanted a DNA test done. After the meeting, the texts and calls switched to calling me a coward for claiming my sister-in-law was lying. This went on for a few more days, before the mounting pressure finally broke my sister-in-law's resolve. She came clean and told everyone who the real father was, being a 15-year-old at her school, that told her to make something up. When this news came out, I still had to go through some whole BS investigation, to show that I wasn't actually a secret child predator. I'm self-employed, so we will see how bad this whole episode is going to screw up my life, and I'm definitely pressing charges against my father-in-law for the damage he did to my apartment and threat to my life he posed. Contrary to what most people on here suggested I do, I am not going to immediately divorce my wife. Our marriage was amazing before this happened, and I don't want to throw that away over a stupid 14-year-old and her boyfriend. I've seen my wife a few times and told her I understand why she did what she did, and that I still want to be with her given that I will not want to be around specifically her father or her sister for a long time, and that before we move in together again, we get marriage counseling. She agreed to those terms and we have been to a few sessions separately and together now. Thanks for the input I got on the old post. Edit, lot of people are acting like this whole situation continued even with DNA evidence proving I was innocent, that's not the case. There never was a DNA test and likely won't be, now that sister-in-law admitted and the actual father confirmed it. The threat alone of a DNA test is what made her tell the truth. I also said I'm not immediately divorcing my wife, it may come to it after we have tried counseling, but I don't know at this time. Yes, I'm hurt by my wife not believing me, but at the same time, we've only been married for a year and a half, and she basically raised her sister while her parents worked and has always been very close to her. My wife didn't cut contact with me through this, I did at the direction of my lawyer. I left my phone with him, and looking back through it now, she never accused me of anything, was just asking questions trying to figure out what was going on. My father-in-law acted out on his own by breaking in, no one knew what he was doing and I don't have any sympathy for his actions and am pressing charges for everything he did. He broke in, not used my wife's keys to get in. The door frame was completely destroyed. Now for the top advice. Keep talking to that lawyer. You might not be out of the woods yet. I would have your lawyer start to build civil cases against all your in-laws. If they threatened you over text, go to the police. Have your lawyer keep up the pressure on the police and prosecutor's office. Edit, I know that lawyers are super expensive for most, but I feel the cost would be worth it in this case. If you have been accused of being a child violator, they are the only ones capable of clearing your name. Also, their homeowner's umbrella policy will cover lost income, if these claims get out. You will need that information to force their insurance to pay. What did your Phil, Sil, and other relatives say after the truth came out? Was there any remorse at all? No idea, I've kept myself away from them. At least they stopped pushing to get me arrested when she finally told the truth. I'm sorry for the terrible circumstances you're in right now. I hope things get better soon. By the way, that's a damn good lawyer you have. I know, I'm calling him from now on for everything. And that's it for this video guys, if you have thoughts to share, leave a comment below. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe if you like this content. I'll catch you in the next one. Good day everyone.